Hello, I'm Dr. Josée Jarry, and I'm a faculty member in the Department of Psychology at the University of Windsor. The important thing is to understand what mental health really constitutes. And what it is ultimately is a biological process. And for us, sometimes it's a little complicated to understand that because we experience it as a subjective state. And of course it is. But that subjective state is rooted in biology. And we know a few things by now about how to take care of your brain, and there's very strong research to support that. Regular exercise is the first thing to consider to keep your brain in good condition and therefore allow you to experience this subjective state of well-being. The first step is just an act of faith, really, and to say, I'm just going to try it. I don't feel like doing it, I don't want to do it, I hate doing it, but I will give this a try. The second thing that we know is about nutrition. And there is now new research showing that even with just 2 weeks of healthy eating, people can reverse clinical depression. And that's not anything extravagant. It's just eating fresh fruit, vegetables, 3 balanced meals a day. The other very strong research that we're accumulating now is about meditation. There's tremendous individual differences in what people need to find this calm. I practice Ashtanga yoga. I'm on the mat 2 hours a day. This is what I need. I've always needed very vigorous exercise to find this calm space. So you have to find this out for yourself. But one thing is certain is that being sedentary is not what is going to make you find that serenity, basically. These things that you can do for yourself are going to create the conditions to make you better able to face whatever COVID is throwing at you.